My name is Doug Besler, and I'm the Mountain Region Fisheries Supervisor with the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission. Our agency first learned of whirling disease from an angler who alerted one of our staff of some deformed fish that they caught on the Watauga River. Our agency staff made contact with that angler, and we went out and sampled the location and saw, in fact, that there were several fish that appeared to have deformities associated with whirling disease or other fish diseases. We then went out and sampled a number of those fish and sent those to Auburn University to a certified disease lab at that location. Those fish ended up coming back positive for whirling disease, which is our first report in North Carolina. Our agency takes those reports very seriously, and we tried to initiate some immediate actions. The first of those was that we suspended trout stocking until our hatcheries themselves can be cleared of the disease, at least as far as a disease lab can tell us. We will initiate stocking as soon as we can get cleared. So immediately, our agency sampled fish from our Setzer State Fish Hatchery and our Armstrong State Fish Hatchery, as well as our Marion State Fish Hatchery, and sent those samples to Auburn University. The second thing we did was we worked cooperatively with a local trout club on the Watauga River who has a stocking permit from our agency, and we had permission to sample that location. We will initiate that in the upcoming weeks. We also are working cooperatively with the North Carolina Department of Agriculture to sample a potential trout production operation located in that proximity on the Watauga River to have those fish and sediment tested as well. And the immediate need for our agency is to try to determine the extent of where whirling disease might be located in the wild, and we'll just go from there. From that information, we'll broaden out our sampling efforts as appropriate, and we're developing protocols internally with our research staff and with our veterinarian. As an angler, we get on a lot of questions about what can they do to help. And the first thing we would automatically tell anglers is do not move fish from water body to water body as a general rule, but particularly from the Watauga River right now. Make sure they're disinfecting all gear. We would prefer that that's done with bleach, 10% bleach solution. You can also expose gear to high temperatures, over 140 degrees. And if anyone's considering stocking a location in the Watauga River Basin, to know that they need a stocking permit from our agency, and we would appreciate that anglers or any homeowners, for that matter, not stock trout in that watershed until we can confirm or deny the presence elsewhere in that system. The other thing that we would ask anglers to do statewide, anywhere they're fishing for trout, is that if they see any fish that fit those characteristics of those that might have whirling disease, such as a black tail, a deformed skull, or deformed skeleton in other manners, is to get in contact with us. And they can do that through our agency's website at ncwildlife.org. They can also contact our biological staff if they know those members, and they can send us pictures of those fish and geographic coordinates of where they might have encountered those fish, and then we can investigate based on that. So we can really appreciate and utilize anglers in North Carolina in these situations. And the goal, ultimate goal from the agency is we cannot do anything about the fish in the Watauga River, but what we can do is limit or hopefully stop the spread of it if it is confined to the Watauga River Basin.